Today we're going to talk to you about your new Galileo G2 computer. Again, our latest innovation in computer technology using our Galileo format. When you first open it and take it out of the box, one of the first things you want to do is always be sure and put it on charge. You'll notice we have a new clever charging device, a dongle with a USB cable. You can see there's some brass fittings. This simply goes right underneath the buttons on the computer and it'll lock into place. And then of course on the other end you have a standard USB. This can be plugged into a laptop, it can be plugged into a wall charger, whatever, and when it gets plugged in, this is what's going to charge your computer. So take the time to plug it in and get it charged up completely first. It'll be a standard battery indicator showing you that it's charged and when it's full, but it will go back to sleep after about 3 minutes, so it's still charging, but it's going to have nothing on the screen after you get the initial prompt showing that it's screening, or it's charging, excuse me. So let's replace this. We'll go ahead and walk you through the startup prompts. So when you first turn on your G2, you'll push the right button. You'll hear a little beep. It's going to show you the Scubapro logo. It'll show you the G2 logo. And then it's going to walk you through some settings. So it's going to say, in this case, factory setting. You'll notice there is an arrow in the upper right corner. It says, "Welcome to the Uvatech Scubapro Diving World with G2. Please personalize your G2 in the next few steps. Thank you." So let's go ahead and hit our arrow. First thing it's going to ask is the languages. The G2 is capable of 19 languages and we're adding more. At this time with this firmware, which is V0.7, the very first language you'll see is English. So let's hit our arrow button. You could go down, you could go up based on the country you're in. We'll hit our arrow. It tells us now that we want to be able to change our units. In this case, it's set for metric. We're here in California, so let's go ahead and change that to be imperial. So it says imperial. I'm going to hit my arrow to confirm. And again, remember we have light presses and hard presses, so all these plus and minus, just like on the Galileos before, are just light presses in order to go up and down. So we're going to set our time zone. The beauty of having the UTC or the time zone is it's a real nice way for you to take any of our products, whether it's the watches or the standard computers, and if you set a UTC code, then you could come in and simply change the UTC and you're not having to change the hours and minutes. Again, we're out in San Diego, so that's -7 from Greenwich Mean Time, which is in England, where the kind of the world clock starts. So let's go down to -7. As you can see, -7. Going to confirm. Change is saved. Okay. Now that we've got it set up, it goes back to our startup screen. And we're going to go ahead and switch to another G2 that we've already set the screen a little brighter for the filming. So I'm going to ease this one out of the way. And this one will be a little sharper for the camera to pick up as we continue to film. And we'll walk you through how you adjust this brightness for your own computer.